Welcome to Soaping 101. Today we're discussing special purpose soap. We know that all soap is designed to clean, but these soaps contain additives that take them to the next level, or special purpose. For example, let's talk about a deodorizing soap for hands. Some may call it a chef soap, a kitchen soap, or a gardening soap. First and foremost, we want it to clean well. So coconut does just that. But we don't want to strip the natural oil from our skin. So we'll add olive and shea butter. Just a note, unsaponifiables is the amount of lipids in an oil that does not react to the lye. A built-in superfat of sorts. We want our soap to include a moisturizing additive. Milk, specifically coconut milk, is a great one, since 24% of its contents is fats. Honey is the germ fighter in this recipe, with its natural antibacterial properties. Oatmeal, or in our soap, oat flour, aids in combating itching and inflammation that may still be lingering on your hands from garden soil or veggies. The inclusion of coffee in our soap recipe is twofold. First, acting as a natural deodorizer, and two, for its exfoliation ability to scrub away grit and grime. In the star of this show, found in citrus rinds, is limonene, or commonly referred to as orange oil, and it's found in the peels of citrus fruits. It's a skin-safe solvent. So the dried orange rind in our recipe will also exfoliate and deodorize. I'm adding an orange-scented fragrance oil, but you can certainly add essential oil or no scent at all. The rest of the soap making is very straightforward. We'll add our lye water to the oils by pouring down the shaft of our stick blender. This avoids splashes. And then we'll blend it until trace is apparent. The point where the oil and the lye water are emulsified together and there's no oil slicks floating on top. Because my fragrance oil tends to discolor a bit, I'm separating out a small portion to tint with water-based titanium dioxide. This is purely for aesthetics. Because I chose to incorporate an accent color in my design, I'll alternate the pouring using the drop swirl technique. We'll leave this uncovered on the counter overnight to saponify. After 24 hours, I can tell that our soap has gelled. And this is evident by the crack on top, where the heat escaped. To avoid gel, you can put your soap in the refrigerator overnight to saponify. This will keep it cool and avoid the gel phase. So let's see if we have a gel ring inside. It looks like the soap gelled and then cooled evenly, and we avoided the occurrence of a gel ring. Just pretty soap. I hope this was helpful and that you learned a little bit about oil properties and additives that you may not have already known. Please share your soaps with us on our Instagram page. Well, that's it for this week. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.